You know what's painful? When you order your RTX 3070 and you have to wait more than 1 month to get it. That's painful, guys. Ciao guys, and welcome back to another episode. My name is Luca, and in today's video I would like to share with you my opinion regarding the Nvidia RTX 3070 for video editing. As video editing software, I use DaVinci Resolve Studio. That is basically the only software that I use for video editing and visual effects, both 2D and 3D. And after 1 week that I'm using this GPU, I can say that it's pretty strong and valid if you work with the 4K resolution videos. For example, with Sony, Panasonic or Canon 4K resolution videos, you will not have any problems at all. So you don't have to create proxy files, or you don't have to convert the files in ProRes before you can start to edit them. So if you are planning to work in 4K, your workflow is gonna be really smooth and a pleasure to work with. The problem starts when you wanna render 6K or above resolution videos, because this GPU has only 8GB of RAM, and if you work with DaVinci Resolve, you know that if you need to work in 6K or 8K compressed video files, you probably need the RTX 3090, because that GPU has a huge amount of VRAM, that it's 24GB, and it's gonna be pretty good for your workflow. So for example, if you're planning to buy the Sony A1 that is gonna record 8K, or the Canon USR5 that also record 8K internally, I think it's way better to buy that GPU, because your workflow is gonna be way smoother. Before I built this desktop editing computer, I was using mostly my notebook. It was having an Nvidia 9040M, so it had like 4GB of VRAM, and it was good enough for Full HD videos and 4K resolution videos if I was going to convert those files in ProRes before I would start to edit the files. But because now I'm working more with visual effects and 3D animations, I need that GPU with more VRAM, so that's why I decided to upgrade my workstation. But if I was going to do just normal video editing, even in 4K, the previous laptop that I had, it's 4 years old, it was pretty good enough. So if you're working with 4K resolution videos, I think you don't really need to upgrade your computer and buy a RTX 3070 right now, because the prices are really high and the GPU is really difficult to find. So if you can wait a little bit, do it until the price go a little bit on the normal level. If you are curious to know about the other components of my computer, I'm using an Intel i7 the generation 10 and 32GB of RAM, and as monitor I'm using the Asus 27-inch 4K, and as a second monitor I'm using a normal LG 1080p monitor. Probably the medium performances of my computer are related to the 4K monitor, because the GPU has to process 4 times the resolution than a Full HD monitor. But if I'm working in a 4K environment, I would like to display and see what I'm doing in 4K. So this GPU is pretty good for 4K resolution videos, but I wouldn't recommend it if your workflow include 6K or 8K resolution video. These medium to low performances with the resolution above 6K or 8K are related to H.264 or H.265 compressed files. I'm not talking about RAW video files. So if you have a Pocket 6K or the Canon EOS R5 and you want to record in RAW with that camera, you will probably don't have any problem to render those files. So if you want to have a future-proof GPU, I would recommend to buy the RTX 3090 with the 24GB of VRAM, because with that GPU, you will probably be able to work at least for 4 or 6 years without any problems. So it is a more future-proof investment. Not really an investment, because the price of the tech is going down, it's not going up, so it's not an investment, it's a purchase. I hope you enjoyed the video, because I really like to make this video, I'm a nerd myself. So thank you for watching, guys, and I hope I'll see you next time. Ciao! By the way, if you like to play some games while you are not working, or during the coffee break, or the sandwich break, or the tea break, during the many breaks you can have during your day, this GPU is pretty good to render almost every game that we have right now in the market. So with a 4K monitor and this GPU, I'm pretty sure you can play a lot of games without any problems. But this is it for real now. Thank you for watching, guys. Bust.